All right, welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Ahmad Doroudian. He is the CEO of BetterLife Pharma. And Ahmad, welcome back. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you, Steve. Good to be back.
Yeah, so you got some information back from the US FDA. We'll get to that in just a second. But I want to do a little bit of background on this study that you're hoping to do and that you got through with this response back from the US FDA. So explain to everyone, this is really targeting depression, right?
Yeah, so for the last year or so, our group has been working on developing our BETR-001, which is 2-bromo-LSD, very close cousin of LSD, for the treatment of mental disorder. We're targeting depression and cluster headache. So where we started about a year ago was really from just a scratch, which is, can we synthesize this on a non-controlled fashion, so we don't need any laws to be changed because these materials are, especially LSD and other psychedelics are controlled substances. So our group was focusing on first synthesizing this compound in a way that doesn't contravene any laws or it doesn't need any controlled substance or special permits. We did that. We put the package together. And then since August, we have sent the material to various research groups around the continent at San Diego, University of San Diego, California, at Carleton University, Eurofund Discovery. So this has been a culmination of putting as much detail in terms of receptor binding, receptor activity at the brain level. Does it penetrate, what's the bioavailability, pharmacokinetics? That's the data we released on Thursday in our press release. And, putting a package together that says, okay, this compound, the way we are making it, the way we are designing the formulation, the way we're looking at its stability, and can we put this in a package? And we have shown it to the FDA so that, along with the other data, to show the FDA that this should this can be administered to humans for the treatment that we're seeking, which is depression.
So obviously they've responded now to give you some advice on that, which is really helpful when you're doing this process because it sort of understands what they're looking for and what you're looking for. So what exactly did they say, Ahmad?
So they basically in general. Confirmed and authenticated our results for the last year or so. They agreed that in most part, the package that we have is the right set of data. And we have a little more work to do on the toxicology side of things. And there wasn't any roadblocks. I mean, in pharma development, Steve, the biggest thing is the FDA. Well, you can put a package together, and if it's haphazard and if it doesn't, if it doesn't check all the boxes, you will get a huge roadblock. And this is the time to go to the FDA to make sure that what we have done in the last year was right, and we are generating, we have the right set of data and plans, clinical plans, that when we start dosing humans, this is all approved by the FDA, so that once that IND, investigation new drug application, is accepted by the FDA, then you don't get months and months of delay in conducting your clinical trial. And we think mental health, as is extremely important right now, and is becoming more and more. And we, our compound, our 2-bromo-LSD. We think it will be a game changer in terms of giving people ability to treat themselves at home without assisted therapy or the side effect of hallucination. And this was really, really a good response from the FDA that we think we're well on our way to conduct these very important trials.
So now, do you make just a couple of changes and then resubmit some paperwork? Is that what has to happen?
Well, we don't have to make changes. What you do at this stage, Steve, you give them what you have. which is what we call a CMC package, which is the chemistry synthesis and all of that. Then you give them what you have so far in terms of stability and your animal data, as well as your dosing regimen and proposed clinical plans. So we didn't want to do everything and go to the end and they go, no, there's a lot of holes in this thing and you need to go back. We don't have to redo anything in what we have done so far. So we'd have to add to the package, which is some what they call a basic toxicology. This is very standard for any drug submission to the FDA to complete the package. So, there's nothing that we really have to redo. We're just going to complete the package, submit it sometime this quarter or early next quarter, and then start our clinical trials, meaning dosing human beings.
Exciting times for sure. Ahmad, thank you so much. Great to update all this and make sure everyone understands what's going on. It's very good news for you and the company. So appreciate it. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Steve. Thank you.
Ahmad Doroudian, he's the CEO of BetterLife Pharma.